come together. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
As we come before our God, let us pause, calling to mind our sins and so preparing to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you come to us in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come again in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Ever-living God, grant that we may always conform our will to yours and serve your majesty in sincerity of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
I ask our children to please come forward. Now, what if I were to tell you that you are just like God's money? What would you think of that? You really are. You're God's money. So the question becomes, how are you going to get spent? Are you going to get spent on good things or on bad things? As you go forward today, think of how God wants to spend you and what that means. Go with our prayer, our love, and our support.
Oh, Lord God, come into A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord to his anointed Cyrus, whose right hand I grasp, subduing nations before him and making kings run in his service, opening doors before him and leaving the gates unbarred. For the sake of Jacob, my servant, of Israel, my chosen one, I have called you by name, giving you a title, though you knew me not. I am the Lord, and there is no other. There is no God besides me. It is I who arm you, though you know me not, so that toward the rising and the setting of the sun, people may know that there is none besides me. I am the Lord. There is no other. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. and Timothy, to the church of the Thessalonians, in God the Father and our Lord Jesus Christ, grace to you and peace. We give thanks to God always for all of you, remembering you in our prayers, and unceasingly calling to mind your work of faith and labor of love, and endurance in hope of our Lord Jesus Christ. Before our God the Father, knowing, brothers and sisters, loved by God, how you were chosen. Our gospel did not come to you in word alone, but also in the power and in the Holy Spirit, and with much conviction. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Show me the coin that pays the census tax. Then they handed him the Roman coin. He said to them, whose image is this and whose inscription? They replied, Caesar's. At that he said to them, then repay to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and to God what belongs to God. The Gospel of the Lord. I have no doubt that there may be at least a few of you gathered here this weekend that I'm hearing this particular gospel passage from Matthew, knowing that next weekend is our annual offertory enhancement weekend, an opportunity to renew and recommit to your financial support, our financial support of your parish, our parish mission and ministry. With the general pattern always being that there's a homily that's focused on that just the week before. So I have no doubt that a few, at least, may be thinking, what a sly dog he is. Look, he picked a time to preach on this when the gospel might just back it up. Now, very honestly, I wish I were that insightful. Truth be told, the convergence of being fed this particular gospel passage in our annual renewal recommitment initiative are really much, much more by accident than any kind of deliberate plan. Still, though, as I prayed and reflected over this past week, I realized that there's so much more that needed our attention. More possibilities for homily directions. Not the least of which is the fact that we continue to be in this month of October with a continual reminder of the importance of the dignity, respect, and preservation of human life from womb to tomb. And how once again this coming November, we're faced with the possibility of that critical conviction being diminished. And not just the unborn, but the well-being of those who carry life for humanity, of parents and their role in managing the health and well-being of their children, their teens, their youth, the absolute protection of all human life, from womb to tomb. My friends, this can never not be discussed and reflected upon enough. I also realize that throughout our world this day, especially in the Ukraine and now Israel and Palestine, violence, terror, and war rages, and the lives of so many innocents have not only been put in jeopardy, but have been senselessly lost, with violence and terror affecting so many others as well, in other parts of our world, in our own country and areas. Gun violence, violence against others. A darkness that invades the lives of far too many, and a darkness that must be overcome. And a path to peace in all situations must not only be found, but followed and adhered to. All of this is worthy of consideration. Each of these are very important. Each call for our attention and effort. But rather than try to focus on one to the exclusion of the others, I looked for and I continue to pray for some sort of common thread. And this weekend's gospel did provide inspiration for that. You see, that common thread can be found in the last line of the gospel passage. And Jesus said, "Then repay to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and to God what belongs to God." Now recall, just prior to that line, Jesus pretty much leaves the Pharisees and the Herodians speechless. By their possessing the coin with Caesar's image on it, and knowing full well Judaic law, we just heard that conviction in the first reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. They're taught that possessing something, anything, that had an image of another claiming to be a god, knowing full well that their faith holds that there's but one God, their attempt to entrap Jesus fails. He catches them in their own plot. Centuries ago, St. Augustine, reflecting on this particular passage from the Gospel of Matthew, stated that we are God's money. Render to Caesar the things that are Caesar's, and to God the things that are God's. To Caesar, his coins. To God, your very selves. My friends, you and I are God's currency. And by virtue of our baptism, everything we spend is none other than Jesus Christ, who came so that we might have life, and life to the fullest. So if we are God's currency, then every living creature is as well. The unborn, the expectant mother, the waiting father, the newborn, the child,
the adolescent, the adult, the poor and the hungry, the elderly person, those who want and need, and those whose lives are more comfortable. The Arab and the Jew, the Ukrainian and the African, those who are black and those who are white, and every color in between. Whatever and whoever we are God's currency. To be spent as Jesus Christ spent his life, doing good and not evil. Announcing the kingdom, spreading good news, and providing the means and the tools necessary for others to do just the same. That, my friend, is the common thread this weekend. When we respond and recommit and renew our financial commitment to the mission and ministry of Our Lady of Victory, we spend God's currency so that the good that we do as a community continues and Jesus Christ continues to be spent through us and because of us. When we do all in our power to protect and respect and reverence human life, we spend God's currency so that lives may grow and thrive and impact in good and loving ways the world that God has created. The world our God has given us to be stewards of, not masters. When we seek ways to not harbor anger and hatred, but rather to seek the way of forgiveness, the path to peace and reconciliation, we spend God's currency so that forgiveness, peace, and reconciliation spreads one person and one soul at a time throughout our world. So render to Caesar the things that are Caesar's, and to God the things that are God's. To Caesar, his coins. To God, your very selves. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. To the God who has created all things, and to the God who sustains all that is, we raise our voice in prayer.
And under the guidance and prompting of God's Holy Spirit, the current synod gathered in Rome may bear abundant truth, and that the church in every land may lift up a prophetic voice On behalf of those who cannot speak for themselves, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That inspiring cooperation of all peoples to work for the common good, leaders of nations may act to ensure the rights of each human person to dignity and respect, and that the current conflicts in the Ukraine, Israel, and Palestine, portions of Africa and the Americas, may come to a peaceful resolve so that the lives of all, especially the innocent victims, may be safeguarded, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all the citizens of Ohio may have awe for the gifts of life and act to protect the unborn and their mothers and fathers, accompany pregnant women in need, and preserve parental rights, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That experiencing the care and support of the whole faithful community, our sick and homebound may be filled with a steadfast hope, especially R. Harbinson, Kelly Castle, John Chargarina, Agnes Clark, Mary Dunkey, James Merriott, Danny Firth, Floss Firth, Deja Ferdinand, Robert Geyer, Julianne Jenkins, Dan Lane, Mary Lombardo, Tom Borkowski, Lynn Mattingly, Chloe Pasco, Greg Rich, Carol Scaly, Paula Simmons, Kaylin Tafini, Tina Testa, and the victims and survivors of clergy sexual abuse in our church may be restored to healing and wholeness, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That inquirers, catechumens, and candidates throughout the church, along with our own candidates for confirmation and readers, may find in us and other communities of faith a strength of witness to returning to God all that is God's, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That missionaries throughout our world may bring the good news of the gospel to those who hunger and thirst, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That fashioned in God's image and bearing Christ's name, we may render to God due worship and to our neighbors the love of Christ, and so help lead others to the Lord, especially those who are currently distant from Him, along with those present in our worship, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have recently died, as well as Armando and Angelina Colella, for whom this Mass is being offered, and the dead, having been called by name and grasped by the hand of God, may find eternal life, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the intentions written in our prayer notes book, along with the intentions and needs that remain deep in our hearts and minds, as well as those we have been asked to pray for through our renewal recommitment initiative, may find favor with God, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
You alone, O God, our Lord, and there is no other. Formed in your image, we bear the imprint of your face, and your name is engraved on our hearts. In a world loyal to other powers, let our lifestyle be governed by the standard of the gospel and the currency of your kingdom. As we render to others the freedom of conscience that is their right, may we freely and generously render to you the allegiance you alone deserve. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Our offertory chant, we sing together, Shelter Me, O God, and it's number 477.
Shelter me, O God, hide me in the shadow of your wings.
for your gifts, that through the purifying action of your grace, we may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve. Through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. In a similar way, when supper was over, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We
we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, and we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer to each other the sign of peace.
Thank you.
Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I have not heard that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The Son of Man has come to give his life as a ransom for many. And we sing together, Jesus, Meek and Humble, and it's number 530.
Jesus, speak and come. body of Christ.
Jesus, make at home
the body of Christ.
By the break of
day,
heaven now
body of Christ.
Son of us and
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that benefiting from participation in heavenly things, we may be helped by what you give in this present age and prepare for the gifts that are eternal. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Always a reminder to don't forget your bulletins when you leave. Take fives or the entrance of the church. Thank you to those giving of your time and your talent. Certainly also treasure that supports your parish's mission and ministry. Envelope users, always a reminder to use the collection boxes. A few bulletin inserts this weekend. One deals with Rake and Run, which probably will take place in early November. Check the insert for details for both volunteers as well as those who are looking for assistance. And a reminder today, too, is our Parish School Religion Day. Preschool is over at the Parish Center shortly. Grades K through 6 are 10 a.m. at the high school. Edge, grades 7 and 8 are 10 a.m. at the Parish Center. And Life Team, grades 9 and 10 are this evening at 5 p.m. So we hope to see all of you there. A reminder, too, that our 80th anniversary visioning and planning meeting will be this Tuesday, October 24th. That's a correction, I misspoke last week. So it's Tuesday, October 24th at 7 p.m. at the Parish Center. Y'all come. As mentioned in the homily and last weekend, this week you should be getting the annual State of the Parish Annual Report, along with materials for this year's Renewal Recommitment Initiative. They were mailed on Friday, so do watch for that in the next day or so. If you don't receive one, please call the Parish Center and let us know, and we'll get you what you need. Next weekend is Recommitment and Renewal Weekend, so please, if before then you've not completed your Renewal Recommitment card, bring it with you next weekend, and we thank you for that. Additional copies of the mailing, as well as the Renewal Recommitment cards, will be available if needed. Thank you not only for your prayers in support of this, but also for your response. The Parish Center offices will be closed until 1 p.m. this coming Wednesday so that the staff may participate in a funeral for one of our staff member relatives. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Let's take the word of God with you. And it's number 382.